Thank you for coming in the early morning. I understand this is something which you normally don't do because this is all a weekend. I'm really grateful for that. Why have Chien-Chi Chang and Liu Yujia for this panel? Because there's lots of interesting connection. And first of all, they are in the film program in the same part of it. And Chien-Chi Chang, a very particular filmmaker, but originally that we have to know that he's a very, very good photographer. And I think as an artist photographer today, that he took a lot of effort and facing a lot of difficult times, I guess, because you have to go into the field, go with the people, and especially with this topic, escape from North Korea. I could imagine how dangerous they are to be in the situation. And another reason of actually inviting Chien-Chi Chang is actually related to this North Korea issue, because another artist, He Xiangyu, also made a film about it called The Swim. So I think why all these artists having this kind of concern with the border issues, with the issue of actually people traveling around and still in this very uncomfortable condition. And also, of course, as everybody knows, the refugee issues, but are they any different? And I think I'm also curious about it. And then with Liu Yujia, to have her here with us, I think it's even more particular because she invents a story. And I'm also curious about whether these gangsters from this area are really existed or it's just made up from her work, Colin Island. I mean, what is really about with, you know, being somewhere else, which is not in China. I mean, both of them like from Taiwan, from mainland China, but concerned about, you know, the Asian areas and about the people from Asia. So I think that's the particular setting that we have here. And I'm really grateful to have both of them join this panel. So I think first, I would like to have, maybe lady first, Yujia, to talk a bit more about her work, about the gangster story, about this man who's kind of monologuing about, you know, his life, whether it's true or you made it up.
This time at the film sector, the Colin Island project was started last year. It's basically on a beach. It's part of the project called Beach. Last year I started to become interested in the concept of landscape, so that's what I was doing. I collected a lot of material, including ready-made video material. So I went to Thailand, Pattaya, and Koh Lanta. And so I spent about 7 to 10 days there. And I wasn't particularly interested in the landscape there.
He kind of told me his story on the island.
So this was the turning point for me and kind of changed my original intent of creation.
So
we talked for about four times, and then I sort of audio taped the whole thing, and then videotaped it. 风景在影像当中它跟一个地方的故事啊或者记忆或者历史所产生的一些关联
and its interactions with the place with history and that's basically what I was trying to do
那是什么样的一个记忆和历史
so what kind of memory or history we talk about you come from China and then Curator is
It is a kind of a
touristic attraction, or why were you there in the first place? Because in the beginning, I wanted to create something that's related to the beach. Facilities, tourist facilities such as hotels, water sports. But the day when I was shooting the landscape, I saw a very touristic landscape, so to speak.
And
so when I heard the story,
his
stories took place on that particular island. So I started to become interested in the landscape. I started to see them differently. So the whole idea of landscape,
it's relationship with the human life.
It's kind of a mutually discovered sort of exploratory relationship. You stop seeing it as just a background photo on a postcard or something, so you start to see things differently, the subcurrent, undercurrents. So you stopped paying attention to
generic
views on the concept of landscape, but rather the idea of living within the landscape, their stories.
So the vagabond and
the authenticity of the story that he related to you, how true was that? I am not particularly concerned about the whole concept of authenticity because probably during the process, there was a bit of an embellishment, a performative element in this. And of course, I have to tell stories to him in exchange for his story. So my primary concern is
his real experience, whether real or fictional, entering into a relationship with the landscape.
When I enter a new setting, when I encounter something that is completely dissociated with my own reality, I make a certain connection with him or with this particular place or with this particular story. So you spent a lot of time discussing with this person, sharing stories of the two of you. So what about Chien-Chi? I believe that your work is not so vague or ill-defined, so to speak. Chien-Chi.
I think with Yujia's work is a little bit ambiguous. I cannot really distinguish whether this is the truth that this so-called a local man who told Yujia the story, because I still doubt about it. But as you just said, they exchange stories. So in a way, I think it's kind of fair that she stay on this position with him. They're equal, and they exchange stories, and you just made the work out of it. But I think with your work, which is very different, because you have to catch so-called the truth with your work. But how much you think you have to present it as the truth? Because as we all know, you have to respect what people have done, and also during their trip, in their difficulty moments. And could you tell us more about your work of the escape from North Korea?
Gosh, we're talking about something that I have been I've been trying to forget, actually. I mean, to a point that I have to talk to my shrink, you know, how to deal with this. But yeah, I mean, it was difficult. I mean, from the very beginning, you know, the China, Russia, North Korea border, all the way, you know, I'm not going to tell you the route because I forget anyway, but all the way to China, Laos border, and then I think we crossed the border, yeah, in the middle of the night through the jungle, and then and then sort of hiding in different places, in different safe houses in Laos. Finally, we crossed Mekong. The moment we crossed Mekong, we were fine. We were in trouble. I mean, if we were caught, you know, if you're caught without any entry permit, I mean, you're going to be in detention center for like 2 months. So yeah, that was it was difficult, yeah. Difficult, challenging. The other part is I cannot show the identity. And you try to compose in such a way that that the image would somehow be not just informational but also emotional, and how you strike that balance, you know, because there is no way I want to I want to show a picture and ruin somebody's life. Forget it. I mean, I cannot deal with that. So just try to be careful, I suppose.
But then why you make it into a film work? Because I know you're a very famous photographer.
Me?
Yeah.
Not according to my ex. No, I'm not famous. Initially, it was a commission from a magazine to do the story, and later there was an invitation for an exhibition to make this into a sort of a video work. So I kind of trace back to everything there, including the the text message, everything. They're all real. And the story was being told by one of the North Korean defectors. Did I answer your question?
Yes.
Okay.
Yujia, why you make this film? Why you make the film and present it to us? What do you think the value of it?
Why you actually shoot this film? What do you think is the value of the film? In fact, when I started shooting this film, it was part of a larger project that was about the beach. So it's kind of a story that I got quite accidentally. I think it could, in a large way, construct a bridge to a world that is largely alien to me. So the story of the vagabond, he is Thai, he has a religious faith, so in a sort of a different circumstance, his different reaction and his different attitude towards life.
但是什么态度?
他的叙述很诙谐
He was kind of funny, humorous. He did not felt that his life was such a disaster or frustration. And when he told me his story, he actually added a lot of his own imagination. My first impression seeing your film
is that he is a storyteller.
He doesn't seem like a real person because he told the story so very smoothly, including he talked about how he successfully became a triad and then how he fell and how he was cheated. It really felt like a Hong Kong movie that I've seen.
Well,
his story was actually quite true because at the time I found a motorcycle driver to perform because he told me his real situation.
他父母, 然后他的,
his parents on this island and how he lived there.
对,
那我想请你讲讲你给他的故事是什么。
What's the story you gave him?
我给他的故事，其实也是包括
the story I gave him, included,
工作啊、感情啊、经历，然后我也虚构了很多。
My own story, my work,
Chien-Chi-Chang,
you know, passion, love,
then what is your story?
I also,
and why you work like that,
you know,
taking
make
this
up a lot of,
so-called initiative to be in that condition. As you mentioned, did they succeed? Those people escaped? Or, I mean, what you deal with that later?
Yeah, otherwise I would not be here. I would not be here telling the story, I suppose. I would have been probably put in some jail or somewhere, I don't know. Even though my editor promised that she would get me out. But I don't know, in the event that if I was caught. Okay, but coming back to your question, I think... even though it was a commission, but I chose to do it because I felt it was right. It was a right story for me. I mean, including what you're seeing, you know, this is the European refugees. But I feel I can put myself in somehow. I don't know. It's kind of. It's the kind. It's. I feel it's my project. So, and of course, it's challenging, and it's not that I have a script or anything. So it's often in the process of making the work. It's also the process of finding the quote-unquote right mythology that what is right. I mean, it's all very personal. So I mean, I can only do projects that I think that is right. There's my projects. If it's something that I feel I cannot really put myself into it, then I don't think I can do it unless I'm late for the child support.
I mean, you have to put yourself into it because you're, as I understand, you're from Taiwan, you're leaving Graz. Mm-hmm. And then when you do the project, where you come from?
Being in Graz, I have two kids, two small kids there, but I don't really have probably half of my life has been on the road, and but in Graz it's a kind of it actually has deepened the feeling of being a stranger on a strange land. I don't know if there's anyone from the German-speaking area, but it's, I was like, it was weird, by the way. So we're talking about perspective or position or...
How you consider yourself if you're doing your project? Because if you travel with those refugees or people try to escape from one place to another, are you consider yourself like where you come from, who you are, and why you're doing the project?
I think all of this. I do think a lot before I raise the camera, but once I'm in that sort of in the zone, I don't really think. But it just there's no way I would put myself in a sort of in a higher position. Often I will probably in the either same level or even lower, and it's but somehow this is the people in some way I can associate with, so probably because of my my immigrant experience in the States. So it was very unpleasant. But anyway, maybe I'm a difficult person too. So.
Yujia, do you have such a situation? Because I can
understand
that Chang-Chi,
when he was shooting, he would feel the pain of others. However, in your work, including those that I've seen before,
you have
some kind of a smooth and romantic and even like a children's story. But you have the experience of studying in the UK.
And how do you see yourself as a creator?
Because a creator, when working many a time, would project themselves into their work. So where comes your projection?
I
feel that
because
most of the time I lived in Beijing.
我觉得现在的这种城市生活也非常的有限, 就是我能接触到的时间。
You know, the life that I can experience is actually very limited.
So
I wanted to create, you know, around traveling and use creation as a
start of work and to shoot something that I totally do not understand.
Maybe a big direction
I have is that
in the process I need to be experiencing something different, and I do have high aspiration for that.
对，但是你遭遇到的这个,
however, your encounters,
你认为它跟你的生活有多大的不同?
Well, those that you encounter, how different do you think their life is from yours?
其实, 有多大的不同,
how different? Well, very different.
包括他人的一个故事, 就是我会把我自己投射到他的经历里面去,
well, try to project myself into their experiences and
他生活的这个环境,
I would also
然后,
observe the environment where they live in.
对,
yeah, I guess that's what I do.
Can I just follow up on this? 怎么说呢? 其实我在
How should I put it? You know, when I take photographs, I think I am creating with my entire body. Because your entire body, when you are photographing, you are quite tense. Well, not really tense. Well, not really nervous, but tense.
Intense.
Of course, you have projected yourself, then you feel tense. Now, if you would set yourself, you know, it's unlike other photographers when they set the cameras on a tripod and then while they shoot, they look at the stock, you know, the stock prices, etc. No, I'm not like that. I can't do that.
All
that I can do is to use my entire body, my body and soul.
How long you spend to make that work?
Which one?
The escape from North Korea.
Gosh. Initially, I was on the road with them for 6 months, then another six weeks, then another 6 weeks, and then I went back for another 2 weeks, and he, of course, in between we stay in touch, and that was from 2007 to 2009. So, on and off. I mean, often I work on like a couple of different projects. So I'll go into this and then come back, so that I can have sort of a time and space to breathe, to decompose, so to speak, and then I can also then I may work on the other project. And, so
you told me you've been to North Korea. Can you tell us a bit more about North Korea?
they have very good kimchi. And probably one of the, you know, the best ice noodle. That's all I remember. Other than that, it's a program, you know, you just follow. I mean, there's no way you can have any contact with the local people. You know, you just follow. I mean, one time I actually took a few pictures of the soldier standing, you know, who is probably an AK 47 or something, and. Of course, you know, earlier the tour guy said, do not take pictures of the soldiers. And I mean, to this day, I still remember a priest who told me that it's better to ask for pardon than permission. And so I just kind of, that's kind of ingrained in my brain. So, and boom, sure enough. He was, the soldier was sort of running towards me with his rifle, and I said, oh shit, what's gonna happen? I mean, I don't wanna die here, you know. So. And I said, And then when I go back, you know, I'll just use the SanDisk Rescue Pro to get all the pictures back, that's all. It's a program. I mean, it's a software, but. I thought we were going to talk about what were we supposed to talk about. I don't remember.
Because the topic is about after manifesto, and I think it's important that we reflect on personal stories. And I do think artist work is like a statement and manifesto itself. So that's what we're talking about. And I think it's important that you reflect on it and tell us the true story. But maybe you can make it up like Yujia did. You can make up a story, you can tell a bit more of how you create the story. But I do think you two have a different quality, you two have different directions. So like what you do for me is very particular, and that's Yujia as well. But would you tell us more about, you know, like, because I understand I was into North Korea because I was into that part of a memory of my childhood to understand, you know, what that means for the people in that country. And I do remember that we're not really allowed to take big cameras, and also we're not really allowed to take photos. Like what you said about taking photo of the soldiers, that's impossible. And then I think it's interesting what you told me, like you were there twice. I mean, how can they don't know your profession and to let you be in there and taking photos?
They do, but they also know that I love kimchi, so they just let me go for the second time. Maybe, you know, if... No, I mean, it's okay. Yeah.
Yujia,
do you have any special stories that you can share with us? You were just now talking about your plan.
The overall plan is the beach. 所以我当时是想针对这一个特殊的空间来探索，就是它跟我们的一些 这种风景，特殊的风景，它跟我们的人类的一些生活，包括历史，就它很大。然后，但我现在也还在开始的的阶段。然后，我其实当时是找了很多现成的素材，觉得特别不够，所以才去到泰国去拍这个片子，然后又偶然得到了这个故事。其实它都属于我对风景的一个这样一个计划里，就是在拍完这个片子之后，我会发现，就是我们看一个风景，它跟一个地方的个人的人物故事，它是有一个互相创造的过程。但是，比如说，当我们知道这个人物的故事，可能我会重新去发现当地的一些我忽视掉的一个风景，所以。它大概是这样，它跟我就是2015年去新疆，就一个特别大型的油田区域拍摄那个片子，它是一个延续吧，就是因为我当时是在那个一个特别大的油田里边行走了一个多月去拍摄了就黑色海洋这个片子。其实我当时我更愿意是把这个片子当成一个旅行散文的一个这种方式来做，里面也有很多风景的片段。
所以在你的项目里面，写作是一个什么样的位置？
写作我其实是把它当跟图像放在一块来看的。就是一方面我们怎么是去看一个地方的这种风景的图像，另外一方面就当我们阅读到这些文字的时候，我们是怎么想象的。所以它是一个在看一个图像过程当中的一个另外一个维度的理解吧。
It is another way or another anchorage of the understanding.
You ask me whether you can joke on the stage or not, and then I said yes. Do you have a joke for us?
I mean, look at the camera. This is going to go on YouTube. This is actually no. Because I was reading that you were talking about positions or something. Maybe I misread. Okay. Anyway, when it comes to I mean to put yourself in the right position, that's very crucial. I mean, in terms of the sound, in terms of the story, the composition, everything, which reminds me of. Is there any minor here? Okay, which reminds me of actually in the early 1980s there was an American golf champion, and he just won all the tournaments, and so the Japanese invited him to Tokyo for a demonstration, and so the moment he arrived, the Japanese extend all the hospitalities, the wining, dining, and by the end of evening, a kabuki as well. And somehow, in the middle of the night, you know, during this, the Japanese was a sexy doll, or. He would hear this woman saying, "Machikatani, machikatani," and he thought he was doing something right. So he would actually even push harder. Anyway, okay. Somehow he remembered that term. The next day during the demonstration, boom, woo, hole in one, woo, and he just shouted it. Machikanani, machikanani, very loud. And all of a sudden, in front of thousands, tens of thousands of spectators and probably millions of viewers in front of television, it was dead silence in the whole country. And after like probably 4 or 5 seconds, his caddy came to him and say, "Sir, why are you saying the wrong hole?" I mean, position is, you know, I mean, we were talking about position, but it's crucial. Okay. Shit, this is going to go to YouTube.
Anyway, so I
but
think...
But it's real. I'm not making this up. Don't ask me to give you the names, but it's real. Okay, this has actually happened.
Anyway, does anybody have questions? We have two very particular artists on stage, and please ask now. No questions? So you're not interested in them? So, by the way, I'm introducing a book from Slavoj Žižek, All These Jokes, which I read it, and I think a lot of jokes are really not making me laughing, and I think they're very particular. And I do think, you know, maybe that's to respond to Chien-Chi Chang's, what he tell us about. But I want you to think over again. And both of them taking their effort, traveled with those people, either in dangerous or non-dangerous situation. But I do think that involvement is very particular, which is gave us much more imaginary kind of space of thinking how to be with the others, and how to spend your time, how you tell their story, whether it's your story reflected through them or their own story. But I do think there's a quality with the exchange and also time that you spend together. So the title of the program I screened with the two of your works are called The War Never Was. Never Was. So for me, that's... I don't know, it's a very absurd title because that gives all the meaning already to think about the truth today. So I thank you for joining us and being on the stage to share your stories. And I do think it's very important that artists still exist and they're taking their position, effort, initiative to being somewhere with those people and telling their story that we don't know. And thank you for joining us and by being with them and with us here, for spending your time. And thank you so much.